And you heard three wonderful comments, speakers, and Raveen is back here. I'm just going to ask them some quick questions, and then I'm going to open it up to you on the floor. Maybe I'll start with Brigadier. You know, you talked about NCC and the new threats which are before us, and you asked the students to, in fact, even talk about what they fall, what can be done. With 15 lakh young people, surely NCC can do much beyond what the army can do, and so much of the threats are actually within us and within our society. Today, you cannot open the paper without reading about some horrific violence. Violence against women, violence against children, violence against each other, violence against communities. And these are threats within. We can fight threats outside, but not necessarily within. Now, how do you do this? How does one transform NCC into something which will really do what you said, which will go towards nation building? And you have only your time.
Okay, fine. I'm actually not known for kind of being very verbose and all that, but then I had to sing a song, right? Now, the motto of NCC consists of only two words: unity and discipline. All right. Somebody has thought very, very deeply when they said, "Look, we'll not complicate things. We'll just put these two words there." If you have unity, you'll have to. If you have to really, really work for it in a country like this. Okay. It is not only diverse in terms of languages and cultures, it's diverse in terms of strata. Okay, within a community, there are stratas. Okay, to make it come together, if you can do that, then most of the conflicts will go away. Okay, conflicts happen because of between the haves and have-nots. So, discipline is required, and those seeds have already been kind of put. Those have already been put. It is there. It's just that to meet these new challenges, the internal threats which are not thought about, that was really very worrisome. That's why I kind of, instead of kind of trying to find a solution for it, I gave it to the young people out here. So we have to really, and I admit, we have to work to update those methods which we use in the NCC. One of them is, we are already doing it in this digital age. We are bringing in digital literacy and how to handle social media and amongst the young people, that we've already added to the curriculum. So this is just one of the baby steps. I actually hope to take a lot from this congregation.
Thank you. You mentioned about digital things, and Reema Ben, when she did her opening comments, she was asking questions. But she was asking one question at the end, which was whether the tools which are available today, are they more empowering, are they more reaching towards a more equitable society? Today, if you see, in many ways, these tools make knowledge. Someone was talking about knowledge today. Knowledge accessible. I was talking to the lady who comes to clean at our place, and I was looking at something on the TV, and she had already seen that same news item earlier, and she could discuss with me what that. It was an international thing, but she could easily discuss that. Yeah, this is the problem, she said. Now that access to knowledge and data, which is now becoming common, is remarkable. And I wanted Reema Ben to sort of tell us how she sees these tools even more being used for making a more equitable society. Reema?
Thank you so much. And I believe that, as you rightly said, if you put these tools in the hands of the poor and the women, they know exactly how to use them in their advantage, especially how to turn them around and use them as an opportunity to generate livelihoods. And that is what we have been doing at Seva way back since 1986, when the first time we put a video into the hands of a vegetable vendor or into the hands of a handcart puller. And she used that video as a tool to bring out the issues of the handcart pullers or of the vegetable vendors. So I think the question is that how do you turn that digital age into an opportunity? And therefore the challenge is on the content. What kind of content, what quality of content that comes out, and how does that content is just and equitable, which even an illiterate woman can use. Let me give you an example. We run a rural distribution network where the small farmers of Gujarat, whatever they produce, we package it and we redistribute through our rural saleswomen. How do you manage inventory? And a completely illiterate woman now uses a mobile app to tell us that, she uses icons. So she has developed icons. So she knows that, if I press umbrella, which means that I have to send message to such and such person. And the message she uses to send me is of a lion. And so that's how, the women turn it into their advantage. And that's the kind of inclusiveness that we have to think of. And the best solutions come from, the poor and the women when it is put into their hands. But unfortunately, most of the research that happens, it all happens in big labs, keeping into consideration the urban masses. And what can the urban educated professional, community, how does they use it?
Thank you. I think the potential of using these tools and how people are using it will be wonderful to go and see actually how people are actually using tools in very different ways than what you and I might think are the normal methods of using these tools. Mr. Dasu spoke about a number of things. One of the things which I thought, Mr. Dasu, if you can just elaborate a little bit, you spoke about change and you said how to fight that change or to take it forward. You need to mobilize people, not only those who you know but also those you don't know. And then there is something like collective action. And then when you talked about dreams, obviously there are some dreams which you can do on your own, but there are other dreams which you can do as a collective. And I was wondering if youth as a group, as they are meeting here, and youth along with each other, how could they effectively mobilize themselves going forward?
One thing that you must know in this world is you cannot walk alone. We are very fond of Rabindranath Tagore's poem that if nobody's listens to your voice, walk alone. Nobody can walk alone. It is impossible. Even if you are walking in a jungle, the track that you are walking on was made by somebody else, the clothes were made by somebody else, the shoes were made by somebody else. As a group, every person should make a network within the gamut of where he is working, and he must have a network outside. Networking is the only solution. Unfortunately, our networking is restricted to Facebook. Follow? I am not on the Facebook, but somehow, sometimes I just glance to it. Everybody is telling us how big he is, how good he is. There is one bakery in Bombay. That fellow, you go to it, I want a birthday cake. He is asking a question. Okay, you want to make me a birthday cake that you are going to exhibit on the Facebook? When you say yes, your 500 gram of cake is going to look this big because it is to be placed on the Facebook. He says, when I do this, the other person will come to and say, he make it a bigger one and a bigger one. This is what is going wrong today. It's okay, it's entertainment. I don't say don't do it. but restrict it as an entertainment. Your job is to make use of collective knowledge that is going on around. Unfortunately, we mix up between information and knowledge. Information that you cannot convert into wisdom and knowledge and finally into results is no knowledge. It is only entertainment. Kaun banega crorepati? The next season will start. Follow. Some people say it gives information. Some people say it gives knowledge. In fact, it neither gives you information nor knowledge. They will ask a question. You will hear an audio clip. Whose voice it is? Is it Dhoni? Is it Tendulkar? अरे धोनी का आवाज है, तेंदुलकर का है, गधे का है, मेरा बाप का कुछ भी नहीं जाता. I don't care. Last season he asked, who is the chief minister of Bihar? Unless you're sitting on that chair trying to earn 5 crores of rupees, you should know. Otherwise, he asked the question, who is the chief minister of Bihar? And your options are Nitesh Kumar, blah, 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 blah. So, you jump in your drawing room. Arey, Nitesh Kumar. If the chief minister of Nitesh Kumar is of Bihar is Nitesh Kumar or Nitesh Kumar, how does it inform you? How does it concern you in Gujarat? You are not staying in Bihar. You are not doing business with Bihar. Unfortunately, right at the stage of a school, we are given quiz programs. And those quiz programs are nonsense. For example, Gavaskar ne century kab mari thi? When did Gavaskar hit a century? How do you want to know it? Why do you want to know it? Achha, you give a correct answer. Immediately we'll ask, against whom? Follow. You give an answer. Which year? Which place? These are all nonsense things. I participated in a quiz program in America. So, after our discussion was over, people said a quiz program. Okay. So everybody was given a bell. 5 people are sitting. We are supposed to answer. First person to press the bell gives an answer. The anchor asks the question, who is the president of Nigeria? Maine phat se maar diya. He said, who? I said, Chagan bhai Bhana bhai Patel. And that fellow says, sorry, maine kaha, are you deaf? President of Nigeria's name is Chagan bhai Bhana bhai Patel. He said, what are you talking about? I said, you ask a foolish question, I give you a foolish reply. Why should I know who is the president of Nigeria? Does it add value to my life? Understand this. Anything that does not add value to your life, which means it does not give you results, is a useless information, is useless knowledge. Don't do it. We have got an overload of knowledge. Are Google pe jaake maine ek din galti se type kar diya time management. 153 million samjhe sites padho. Teen jindagi lagi nikal jayegi padhte padhte. Follow. And so, now take a real example. What is the population of Ahmedabad? Somebody gets a 60 lakhs, somebody gets a 50 lakhs. Are Bahar mein ke, why do you want to know? You know that if your brand new Mercedes is going to get a scratch in half an hour of your purchase. That is the population of Ahmedabad. But one of the girls here, she wants to open a beauty parlor. Now she has to know what is the population of Ahmedabad. How many men, how many women between the age of 14 and 40 who will go to beauty parlor? Where do she open the open beauty parlor? Naroda, Naror, Vastrapur, where? That is for her, she can translate that information into knowledge. For the rest of us, what is the population of Ahmedabad? From 1 to 10 million is the correct answer. Chodo. So, only 3 things you should remember. Number one, networking karo. And to you, everybody loves a car. I have made a model of CAR car. You must have commitment, accountability and responsibility. If these 3 things are in you, everything is all right.
Thank you so much. And such an important point that in today's age where information or data is really available straight away, we continue to ask questions which are based on just trying to remember information. And I think what the point is making is extremely important. something which we tried in Indian systems is that, you know, when they give you a mathematics problem, they give you some data at the top and you use it and solve the problem. Now this is not what happens in life ever, that you get the data. So if you give people two more information bits, try it in any one of your exams. Just give information which is not given. Specific gravity of lead is so much. The poor student keeps on going around saying, "Ye to I'm not using, so there must be something, maybe I'm getting it wrong." Because we don't know how to use data. And I think what Dasur is saying is that data information becomes useful if you first know what you're trying to do and how you're trying to use it. I would now like to open it up to the floor for anyone. You would please raise your hand. I think there might be a mic somewhere. And if you can, yeah, there are people in the aisle who have the mic. There's a hand right at the back there. If you can just say your name and where you're from and then ask a question, be short as possible. We are going to take a few questions before we get anyone to answer it. Yes, please.
Hello, I am Noble Philip. I am from Jamnagar. I have one question to ask. I had a question for you all. What is the advice for today's youth? What is the advice for today's youth? As you all know that.
Yes.
Ask.
What is the advice for today's youth that you all know that they are moving in the wrong direction as they are going into the drugs, social sites? What is the good advice from you all for them, the youth?
I'm going to take more questions first, then we'll get the panel to answer it, respond to it.
My name is Karan and I'm from Vadodara. And ask my question. I want another round of applause for Dasur sir, please. Okay, I heard a lot of talk about connectivity, and while it is a necessary factor in functioning or in practicality, our generation basically lacks that practicality. We have stopped functioning in a realistic manner. And I would like to ask how it can be incorporated into us again. And as Brigadier Sir said, that they were the big boomers, and I absolutely agree. And India is right now surviving on a falsified image that was created by those generations. And now we have survived on that we are that. They created that, and there will come a time when someone will show us that was the past. This is your reality. What do we do at that time? Because I think that is required. And the current stance coming up towards India will show us a reality that might even wake us up. So how should the generations that are pertaining right now be prepared for that?
My name is Darshini Parekh. I'm from Ahmedabad. My question is to B.N. Dasur sir. Sir, you addressed in your speech that dreams, you should see such dreams which are your strength. So, sir, imagine a young child who's of 16, 17 years, whose father is a vegetable vendor. That child goes to a municipality school, wherein there is no education system proper, wherein the child does not get any facilities. How would that child identify his strength and then help to the nation? Thank you.
Dasur sir, I have an objection on your topic of that quizzes. Of what you said about quiz, that quizzes are useless and we. Sir, according to the speech of Steve Jobs, where he said about connecting the dots, that every small things in his life helped him to build his Apple empire.
Yeah.
I want to ask the question to to Daspur sir.
Just introduce yourself first.
I am Naman Jain from NRBBN. And I wanted to ask that sir, you talked about not knowing the knowledge which is not relevant to us. So why are we having a subject like history in our syllabus?
Judges, this is Shivalika Chaturvedi. I'm from Gani Ram School, Wellspin. So my question here is, we are continuously pitching on save environment, save water, save blah blah and blah. The thing we are doing right now is cutting trees, making paper out of it, writing save trees and then campaigning. What are we doing? We are cutting trees, making paper out of it and then writing save trees on it. We need to manage, we need to function, and we need to have a better sense of finding out solutions. Campaigning is not the only solution we have found. It's very contradicting. You use the same thing for saving the same thing. You're exploiting the same resource for saving the same resource. Thank you for listening.
Hello. Hello, my name is Ritwik Joshi. I just want to ask you all, every 6 months or every year we find that every community is fighting for reservation in most three states now, being that Maratha has joined in Maharashtra. How would you stop that thing or... I can talk. How will youth कैसे
नहीं ये समझ आते हैं we can understand how does youth what can youth do about this
yes sir
asking about it. That's fine, thank you very much.
Sorry sir.
No.
I have a question for Dastu sir. I want to say that general knowledge is basic knowledge. We have the right to know it. We should know it. It's basic knowledge for the youths to know it. We cannot progress in a country without having general knowledge. I want to ask you why we have a subject like science in our syllabus. Why we have to read chemical reactions like HNO3, carbon dioxide. Why do we want to know this? That's all I want to say.
We are going to take two more questions and then we'll get the panel to comment.
Good evening sir, this is Kudrat Goswami from Christ College, Rajpur. So my question to you as well as the students is, like we are from India and we are telling that India is a nation of culture. But what is current thing? Like we are adopting the other culture of other nation instead of ours. For example, our mother tongue is Hindi, but we are focusing on English. Like we had the Deep Prajwalit, but no one is knowing the reason behind why we enlightened the lamp. And they are, you know, like we have movies like Spider-Man Homecoming. Then search for Spider-Man Homecoming instead of why we enlightened the deep. So what is the thing for that? Thank you.
I think we need to take some questions on this side. There are at least four hands up there, maybe five.
I think you should just take some.
Hello, I'm Nahreen from Bangladesh. Sir, there are many introvert people in our society. So many talents get wasted because they can't express themselves. So my question is, how can a young person understand that he has the potential to do something? Thank you.
Good evening, respected panelists. My name is Abhishek Arora and I am from GLS Law College, Ahmedabad. My question is, on one side, Bharat Sarkar says that Gohatya is a paap. It is not in Indian morality. And on the other hand, India is the largest exporter of beef. So what are your comments on that?
Good evening to one and all the respected delegatories. I am Alpa Darwani from Rajkot. I have a question for Reema ma'am. Ma'am, you said that knowledge is a key point for removing the unemployment. But being educated, when I am getting a degree, I am having a loan for that. Why would I do the self-employment when I am not able to pay the loan? At the same time, I am not getting the job also to pay a particular loan. So the gap between the educated unemployment and the job opportunities that are available to people, is the knowledge actually the reason or a solution to remove the unemployment and poverty in India?
Good evening, sir. My question to Dastu, sir. Sir, I respect your views, but I have only one question then. How bad it is to just have a knowledge or information about who is the chief minister of Bihar? Isn't it that our moral responsibility for awareness purpose that we are living in a union of India? So isn't it our responsibility to have awareness about which state is managed by which leader, sir?
What's your name, sir? What is your name?
Aniket. Sir, my name Aniket from Rajkot Atmiya College.
My question is to Brigadier sir. Sir, my name is Ansh Binivale. I am from RJ Nagarwal College. My question is to Brigadier sir. Sir, is there should be a compulsory military training in order to inculcate the discipline for in the young generation, like that it is compulsory in Switzerland and Israel and Ukraine?
Very good evening to all the dignitaries. As we all know, India is a narrow-minded society, and according to me, the basic root of all the problems is the narrow-minded society. So my question is, how to change narrow-minded India into broad-minded India?
Thank you. I think we are running out of time. I can see many more hands going up, but I think I will just now, let me just get the panel to comment on it. And I think many other questions maybe we could get them written and taken, because I think other people can also answer them later. Maybe I start with Reema. Do you want to start?
I'll take maybe three or four questions and start with the question of educated unemployment and unemployment in general. And I think the root causes are education system. We all are trained to believe that if I go to school, when I go to college, I cannot pursue the same occupation that my family was doing. But I think in our education, we also need to give equal emphasis to skills. And that's the root cause. If in India, and to answer the question of a narrow-minded society, how do you become more progressive? We only give weightage to professional skills. So if I'm a chartered accountant, I'm an engineer, I'm a doctor, I'm an IT professional, everybody feels, wow. But why can't I be a carpenter? I can be a skilled carpenter, I can be a skilled plumber, I can be a hand pump mechanic, I can be a technician, but we all don't want to be that. And that's where the root cause lies. There's no harm if I'm just a driver. In my organization, I have all graduates and postgraduates who are drivers. It's a dignity that we need to give to every skill and every occupation. And unless and until, it's not that one person will change. We all have to come together and start thinking differently. And that's where then the gap will be narrowed. And that's where every skill, every young hand, no hand should sit idle, and every person in this country and in this world needs to have meaningful, dignified work. And so it's not job, it's the work that needs to be given dignity. So I think that's one thing which I tried to answer. The question on dreaming for a vegetable vendor's daughter. I work with 90,000 vegetable vendors in the city of Ahmedabad alone and around 16 lakh vegetable vendors in the country of India from 21 different states. Who says a vegetable vendor's girls or boys don't dream? I can show you thousands of vegetable vendors' children who went to become engineers, who went to become doctors. It is we who have to change our perception. It is we who have to change our mindset. And I relate your question to our sister from Rajkot. We have to look up to everyone as brothers and sisters, as comrades. I am not a brigadier here, but that's the comradeship that we all need to have. It's not that only the educated have the right to dream. Every person on this world, I won't even say our country, has the right to dream. And yes, when we start dreaming, the more bigger you dream, the more closer you try to achieve, go closer to your dream. And therefore, I don't agree to hum honge kamyab ek din. This is what we sing every day. That's how you bring sisterhood and solidarity. So what if I'm vulnerable? So what I'm poor? But one day, I have that deep confidence in me. It's that deep confidence within that will help you to dream. And that's the strength that what Dr. Dastoor is trying to say. It's not the strength that will come from outside. It's your inner self-confidence which will allow you to dream and dream bigger and dream deeper. And I would like to come to the question of practicality that our brother from Vadodara has been asking. And I would like to say that look at the floods that came in Chennai 2 years ago, or the floods that came in Gujarat very recently, just last week. People came out in whatever possible way as citizens, and they offered any help that they could. I think what is needed is an agency that would channelize it, that would channelize that action into a longer term development. And this is what we call at Seva as correlation. How do you correlate? You know, what I think, what I speak, what I do will impact everyone around me, be it in my class, be it in my home, be it in my community. And so I think I would urge you all young people that think in correlation. Tomorrow you all may become vice presidents of companies, or you may have your own companies, or you may be executives or managers. But think in correlation. And I think that is what will bring about the change. Thank you so much. Thank you.